हेलो एवरीवन, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर शिवाकांत पाठक हियर विथ यू टू सी अ टॉपिक थ्योरम ऑन मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया। सी व्हाट इज अ थ्योरम टू कैलकुलेट द मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया एंड व्हेन इट इज यूज्ड। द थ्योरम ऑन मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया इज यूज्ड व्हेन दिस इज अ कंडीशन व्हेन मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया आई ऑफ ए रिजिड बॉडी इज गिवन। थ्योरम वी आर यूजिंग व्हेन मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया आई ऑफ रिजिड बॉडी इज गिवन अबाउट एक्सिस ऑफ रोटेशन, अबाउट गिवन एक्सिस ऑफ रोटेशन एंड इफ वी वांट मूवमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया ऑफ सेम बॉडी अबाउट एनी अदर एक्सिस ऑफ रोटेशन। सी मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया ऑफ बॉडी इज गिवेन अबाउट एनी एक्सिस ऑफ रोटेशन एंड इफ यू वॉन्ट टू कैलकुलेट द सेम अबाउट डिफरेंट एक्सिस ऑफ रोटेशन दिन थ्योरम ऑफ मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया थ्योरम ऑन मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया इज यूज। Normally we are using two type of theorem to calculate it. The first one is theorem of parallel axis and second is theorem of perpendicular axis. So two theorems are used under different conditions to obtain the moment of inertia of a rigid body in a condition that if its moment of inertia is given in the about the other axis of rotation. So first of all we are going to see theorem of parallel axis. See what is the theorem of parallel axis here in this case. To calculate the moment of inertia of a body by using theorem of parallel axis, let us see the statement of it. Statement of parallel axis. This is according to this theorem. Theorem. Moment of inertia I of a rigid body. See carefully to understand the statement of the theorem of parallel axis. Here you are requested to see this diagram very carefully. See this rigid body here. Let this point denotes center of mass, center of gravity. And if moment of inertia of this body is given about the center of mass, this center of mass is given here x and y. This is axis of rotation about this. And it is asked to calculate about any other axis any other access here, A, B, here in this case. Any other access A and B. If we have asked to calculate the moment of inertia about AB of the rigid body, and if we are knowing it, this AB axis of rotation is let h distance away from the center of mass. Here, let a particle is here at this position having mass mi, and this distance is ri. Is the distance here? It is given. Now see very carefully here in this case. Now see this statement, student, which we are going to do it. According to the theorem of moment of inertia I of a rigid body about axis of rotation, see in the diagram AB. If you want to call, according to this theorem, moment of inertia of a rigid body about the axis of rotation AB is equal to, see very carefully, moment of inertia I about AB is equal to what? Equal to first moment of inertia about center of mass, what is this in the diagram? XY plus what? Product of mass of rigid body. Mass of rigid body M plus product of mass of rigid body and square of perpendicular distance between axis of rotations. This is H, perpendicular distance. In mathematical expression, this moment of inertia about AB is equal to moment of inertia about center of mass XY plus mass of rigid body into square of perpendicular distance. See very carefully this box. See here in the equation number 1, here in this case, when we are using the theorem of parallel axis, the diagram, see very carefully, XY is one axis of rotation, axis of rotation passes through center of mass, and it is axis of rotation here nu, through which the moment of inertia is required to calculate. It is sum of moment of inertia around axis of rotation about center of mass plus mass of rigid body plus mass of rigid body into square of perpendicular distance between both. This is mh square plus of this. Now we are going to see proof of this theorem. So see very carefully the proof of this theorem. The above diagram is a system of n particles having masses m1, m2, up to mn, and डिस्टेंस टेंसेस फ्रॉम सेंटर ऑफ मास इज आर वन आर टू आर थ्री अप टू आर एन राइट. लेट अस सी द रेस्ट थिंग इन द नेक्स्ट पेज. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सी मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्सिया. About center of mass, by the definition of moment of inertia, it is I center of mass, axis of rotation is xy passes through that, is equal to summation I is equal to 1 to n mi ri square. It is represented by equation number 1. Now we are going to see by same formula moment of inertia about axis of rotation AB. It is given by AB. This is also system of n particles. It is summation I is equal to 1 to n mi. Now see the distance from new axis of rotation of this mi particle. It is ri distance and it is h distance. So it can be written as h plus ri whole square. Write this is here in this equation we may write summation I is equal to 1 to n mi and open this bracket h square plus ri square plus twice h ri. See here in the diagram the same thing can be written as moment of inertia about axis of rotation AB is equal to summation I is equal to 1 to n mi h square plus summation I is equal to 1 to n mi ri square plus summation is equal to I is equal to 1 to n mi into twice h ri. See this equation everyone. Let this equation is represented here by 3. This is equation 2. Because in the statement the equation is given first equation. Now see carefully here with this. We are going to calculate the various quantity here. See carefully. This is mi h square and this is here. It is a moment of inertia. See this is box center of mass. Right? So before knowing this, see how we are going to see. This is a big question. Since moment of force. Here is force W weight. Because weight of the rigid body is mg, right? Moment of weight about center of mass is zero because whole mass is supposed to be act at center of mass. What this represent here? What is the mathematical mean of this? Mathematical mean is I is equal to 1 to n mi. Weight is mig. m1g plus m2g plus m3g up to mng. Summation this is. In two moment this is a distance ri is equal to 0. Or this again implies that here g we may take out because it is a constant. समेशन आई इज इक्वल टू वन टू एन एम आई आर आई इज इक्वल टू जीरो. दिस इंप्लाइज दैट जी कैन नॉट बी इक्वल टू जीरो. सो प्रोडक्ट ऑफ टू क्वांटिटीज जीरो. आर दिस इंप्लाइज दैट समेशन आई इज इक्वल टू वन टू एन एम आई आर आई इज इक्वल टू जीरो. Now see, it has a equation number 4. See very carefully the equation 3 here in the picture. First of all, see this is a situation here in the, if we take 2H as a constant outside, then in that condition it's become MIRI. Then this total factor, see the box with green color, it is a 0. So we may write using equation 4, equation 3 can be written as, see it is, total is about moment of inertia about the given axis of rotation is equal to summation I is equal to 1, 2n, mi, h square. Plus c, this is box in the black. It is moment of inertia using this equation to about center of mass. Center of mass, axis rotation xy, this is plus. And the rest factor is a 0 using 4. Using equation 4, this we use equation 4 and 2, then equation 3 can be written as in this form, or by rearranging this equation can be written as moment of inertia about AB is equal to moment of inertia about center of mass passing through xy here in the diagram plus summation I is equal to n to n 1 to n mi h square, right? And this is the proof of this theorem number 1, that is theorem of parallel axis. Now we are going to see statement and proof of theorem of perpendicular axis. See, first of all, theorem of parallel axis is used to obtain the moment of inertia in case of three dimensional shape body, but it is for 2D shape body, rigid body, two dimensional shape rigid body. Two dimensional rigid body is called lamina. So first of all, understand the mean of lamina. So this theorem of perpendicular axis is used for a lamina. So first of all, see the diagram before the statement, and with help of this diagram we will write the statement of the theorem. See, if we have a two dimensional lamina is available here, right? This is two dimensional plane. This two-dimensional plane is called lamina. See very carefully. Here in two-dimensional plane, see the frame of reference here. In this case, x-axis, y-axis and z-axis. We are choosing here in this way, right? Three axis are used as three axis of rotation. One OX axis of rotation, one OY axis of rotation, and here OZ. We are considering a particle whose mass is given MI and its position from here it is given RI. So here the position here on the axis OX here represented, let it is XI and here OYA. See very carefully the diagram, right? If we know, if you want to calculate what this theorem speaks, if you want to calculate the moment of inertia of two dimensional lamina about an axis of rotation perpendicular to the plane lamina, means OZ, so it is equal to the sum of moment of inertia around X axis plus moment of inertia of the plane lamina about Y axis, right? So this is the statement of this theorem. So by this diagram, see this statement. What is this statement? The moment of inertia, the moment of inertia I about OZ, here in the diagram, OZ is what? Perpendicular to plane lamina. Lamina is equal to, see, we are going to obtain the moment of inertia of a body about axis of rotation OZ. So it is equal to, what it is equal to? See very carefully, it is equal to sum of moment of inertia of lamina about two perpendicular axes OX and OY. This is equal to OY. Mathematically speaking, that IZ is equal to IX plus IY. See here in this diagram. This diagram and this equation, we are going to represent equation number 1. Now we are going to see proof of this statement. So before going to prove, see this diagram very carefully here. Focus here on the diagram. This is a plane lamina. This is not a body in three-dimensional space. And moment of inertia of this lamina we are knowing about axis of rotation OX and OY. Then by using this theorem, we can calculate the moment of inertia of the lamina about perpendicular axis OZ here in the diagram. And according to this diagram, moment of inertia around OZ is equal to moment of inertia around OX plus moment of inertia about axis of rotation OY, right? See, so IX is the moment of inertia about OX. See this formula and here. Now see how we are going to calculate here. First of all, in the proof, we are going to see moment of inertia about OX. It is represented by IX. See here in this diagram, here once more, if you are moment of inertia about OX, see here, so the particle is what distance from the axis of rotation? YI, not XI. Right? What is the distance of particle? If you want to see this particle and it is rotating about this particle, or rotating around OX axis here like this. So what is its distance from origin? See here in the diagram, yi. What is this distance? Yi. So moment of inertia of this particle can be given m1 y1 square plus m2 y2 square plus and so on up to n particle, or it may be written summation I is equal to 1 to n mi yi square. It is ix, and this ix is represented as equation number 2. Clear? Similarly, moment of inertia, about OJT, OY. In that condition, IY is equal to summation I is equal to N to N, 1 to N MI. Now, in X axis, if distance is YI, so here is a distance XI square. This is equation third here. So this is IX and IY we have written here. Now what we are going to do? Adding equation second and third we have. So in the left hand side it is become IX plus IY. This is equal to summation I is equal to 1 to n mi yi square plus summation I is equal to 1 to n mi xi square. It can be written as summation I is equal to 1 to n mi is common. Here can be rearranged at xi square plus yi square. Now see, this is IX plus IY. Now see this term which is underlined by green color, XI square plus YI square. See in this diagram in the beginning once more, XI is this, YI is this, and it is RI. See by vector notation, RI is equal to under root XI square plus YI square, or we may write RI square is equal to XI square plus YI square. See it is. So using this relation, we may write here. See here in this, since R square is equal to XI square plus YI square, so using this what we may do? Summation I is equal to 1 to n mi ri square. It is ix plus iy. See here. And we are going to represent it by equation 4. This equation 4 speaks a lot. Now see this underlined term here in this question very carefully. This is the underlined term, mi ri square. See again, focus here in the diagram. See this ri distance, it is from ox, oz axis of rotation, which is perpendicular to ox and oy plane, r plane of lamina, because it is a two dimensional body. So in that condition it can be written as ix plus iy here in the left side, and it is moment of inertia about z axis, because iz is equal to summation I is equal to 1 to n mi ri square. So this is equation. It is proof of theorem of perpendicular axis. So I hope you understand well. थैंक यू एंड हैव अ नाइस डे टू ऑल।